Dear listeners, tonight I invite you to step into a world of magic and courage, where mysteries and adventures intertwine in our story. Sit comfortably, close your eyes, and let the tale carry you into a silver forest, where a magical wolf watches over nature. The Silver Wolf. Magical Adventure in the Enchanted Forest. In times when magic was part of the world's fabric, and forests harbored secrets and wise creatures, there were people who could still communicate with nature and understand the secret language of the elements. In these magical times, it was natural for the destinies of mortals to intertwine with those of enchanted lands. In such a forest, known as the Silver Forest, lived a young girl named Rhea. Legend said that the forest was inhabited by protective spirits and magical creatures, hidden from the eyes of outsiders. Rhea, with her chestnut hair and bright eyes, had a special bond with nature. Raised in a village on the edge of the forest, she was taught by the elders to respect and protect the forest's magic. One quiet night, filled with the silence of nature, the sky was covered with a mantle of stars, and the full moon shone with a gentle silver light. Rhea lay in her simple bed, in her modest house at the edge of the Silver Forest. She had fallen asleep, thinking about the beauty of the forest, the murmuring of the streams, and the song of the birds, slowly drifting into dreams. However, that night would be different. In her dream, Rhea found herself in the middle of the forest, under the moonlight that seemed to flood everything with a magical aura. Suddenly, a silver wolf appeared from the shadows, moving with grace and dignity. Its fur gleamed with an unseen brightness, reflecting the moonlight, and its eyes shone like two distant stars, full of wisdom and peace. Rhea felt that this wolf was not an ordinary being. It radiated a calm and powerful energy, like an ancient guardian of the forest. The wolf approached Rhea without fear, and she felt an immediate connection, as if she had known it forever. With a calm and deep voice, the wolf spoke to her, introducing itself as Lycos, the guardian of the Silver Forest. Its voice was like a gentle echo through Rhea's mind, soothing her soul and giving her a sense of safety. Lycos began to tell her about the forest, about all the creatures that inhabited it, and the harmony that reigned there, a harmony he had protected for centuries. But his tone changed when he reached the main subject of their meeting. Lycos spoke of a serious threat on the horizon, a danger that could destroy the forest's delicate balance. A dark sorcerer named Moros planned to extract the magical essence of the forest, the source of its life and energy. Moros was not just an ordinary sorcerer. He fed on the power of darkness, on the dark forces that destroyed everything in their path. He sought to amplify his powers, even if it meant destroying the forest and upsetting the natural balance of the world. Rhea listened intently, feeling a weight in her heart at the thought of the danger threatening the place she loved so much. Lycos explained that only someone with a pure heart and a deep connection to nature could thwart Moros' plans. Rhea, with her rare ability to communicate with plants and animals, was the only hope. Lycos told her that to protect the forest, she needed to discover an ancient artifact known as the Heart of the Forest, which had the power to counter Moros's dark magic. As Lycos spoke, Rhea felt a wave of responsibility settle on her shoulders. She was not just an ordinary girl. The destiny of the forest and all its creatures depended on her actions. The Silver Wolf told her that this mission would not be easy. She would have to face many dangers, overcome obstacles, and confront her fears. But he also assured her that she would not be alone. The spirits of the forest would guide her, and he, Lycos, would be by her side, offering advice and protection. Lycos ended his story with a final warning. If the forest were lost, not only would the creatures and plants suffer, but the entire world would lose a part of its beauty and balance. Rhea needed to be brave and trust in herself, in her bond with nature, and in the help of her friends, both human and magical. Rhea awoke suddenly from her dream, her heart pounding in her chest. The memory of the Silver Wolf and his wise words was still fresh in her mind. As dawn began to light the horizon, Rhea knew there was no time to lose. Her clear and urgent vision pushed her to act immediately. The village where she lived, small and isolated at the edge of the Silver Forest, was known for its legends about the magic of the place. The people there lived in harmony with nature, respecting and loving every aspect of it. Although the villagers did not possess magical abilities like Rhea's, they were aware of the ancient stories that spoke of the spirits of the forest and the magical creatures that protected it. Raised with these stories, Rhea felt that she was now part of one of them. With determination, Rhea began to prepare for the journey ahead. She knew it would be a long and dangerous road, so she took only the essentials: a canvas bag with some provisions, a warm cloak, and a small knife for protection. The forest would provide the rest, as long as she respected and protected it. Lycos, the Silver Wolf who had appeared in her dream, now showed up in the real world, guiding and protecting her throughout the journey. With each step she took into the forest, Rhea felt a deeper connection to the place. As she advanced through the dense thickets, she discovered breathtaking landscapes and magical creatures that seemed to watch her with curiosity. Each encounter was a test and a lesson. At one point, Rhea came across an old, rickety rope bridge that spanned a deep ravine. As she carefully stepped on the fragile planks, a strong wind began to blow, causing the bridge to sway dangerously. With her heart in her throat, Rhea clung to the ropes, but found her balance by remembering her grandmother's teachings about courage and calm in the face of danger. As she progressed, Rhea met the protective spirits of the forest, ethereal and graceful beings who offered her advice and support. They spoke to her about the delicate balance that had to be maintained and the dangers that might arise. They explained that the forest itself was alive and felt every change and intention. These spirits saw in Rhea a trustworthy ally and decided to assist her in her mission. but not all encounters were friendly. One day, Rhea was attacked by a giant carnivorous plant hidden beneath the soft soil. With powerful roots and sharp thorns, the plant tried to ensnare her. Surprised and scared, Rhea managed to escape, only thanks to her quick reflexes and Lycos' help, who bit fiercely at the roots to free her. This incident served as a clear reminder of the hidden dangers lurking at every turn. On another evening, as the sun set, Rhea came across a group of naiads, water spirits, dancing gracefully on the surface of a crystal clear lake. The naiads, with their long, shimmering hair like water, sang a hypnotic melody, trying to lure Rhea into their midst. Mesmerized by the beauty of their song and dance, Rhea almost forgot her mission. However, Lycos sensed the danger and barked, snapping Rhea out of her trance. Realizing she was about to be bewitched by the naiads, Rhea gathered her strength and gently refused their invitation to enter the water. The naiads, though disappointed, respected her decision and retreated into the depths of the lake, allowing Rhea to continue her journey. Despite these challenges, Rhea felt increasingly connected to the forest. Every corner of the forest seemed to speak to her, revealing its hidden secrets. She listened to the whispers of the wind through the leaves, the murmur of the waters, and the song of the birds, feeling the forest accepting her, recognizing her as one of its protectors. This feeling gave her strength and courage to continue, regardless of the obstacles that might arise. Rhea remembered Lycos' words about the dangers awaiting her. She knew that Moros would not stand idly by and would try to stop her. Nevertheless, she did not feel alone. Besides the support of the forest spirits, Lycos was always by her side, a constant and comforting presence. The wolf did not speak often, but when he did, his words were full of wisdom and guidance. Rhea felt grateful for this reliable ally and for the forest's trust in her. On a dark night, under a pale moon, Rhea ventured deeper into the silver forest. The wind blew fiercely, and the leaves rustled strangely, as if whispering warnings. Rhea felt a growing unease, and the shadows seemed to move on their own, creating a frightening atmosphere. Suddenly, from the shadow of the trees, a pack of black wolves appeared, different from those in the fairy tales of her childhood. Their eyes glowed with a menacing red light, and their movements were precise and coordinated, as if controlled by an external force. Rhea immediately understood that they were under Moros's influence. With her heart pounding wildly, Rhea tried to defend herself, but the number of wolves was overwhelming. In those moments of despair, Lycos appeared, more radiant and imposing than ever. The silver wolf positioned himself between Rhea and the dark wolves, emitting a gentle but powerful light. With a warning howl, Lycos made the dark wolves hesitate. Rhea, feeling the courage emanating from Lycos, gathered her strength and began to recite a protection incantation she had learned from the forest spirits. The silver light of Lycos intensified, enveloping Rhea and repelling the dark creatures. The wolves, disoriented and frightened, eventually retreated, leaving Rhea safe. This encounter was just the beginning of her trials. As she continued to advance through the forest, Moros did not cease to hinder her. One day, Rhea reached a wide and turbulent river whose waters were known for their ability to attract lost souls. On the opposite shore, a stone pathway led to the next part of the forest, but the only way to cross the river was a narrow and shaky bridge made of ropes and old planks. Rhea knew that a mistake could be fatal, but her determination was unwavering. With each step on the unstable bridge, she felt the wind trying to unbalance her and the planks cracking under her weight. When she was nearly halfway across, a giant wave rose from the river, threatening to knock her down. In those critical moments, Rhea remembered the advice from the forest spirits. Be one with nature. Let yourself be carried by its energy. She closed her eyes, took a deep breath, and felt the wind and water become her allies, not enemies. With unexpected grace, she managed to cross the bridge and reach the other side safely. On another occasion, Rhea was drawn to an abandoned village where the houses were mere ruins covered with moss. The atmosphere was heavy and oppressive, and the silence was broken only by the sound of her steps. As she explored the place, she encountered a mysterious figure, an old man with a white beard and deep eyes. He told her that he was a forest spirit, a being who once protected the place, but was now bound to the land by a curse. He tried to convince Rhea to abandon her mission and stay in the village, saying that the outside world was full of dangers and she had no chance against Moros. Rhea felt a moment of doubt, but remembering Lycos and all the beings she had met in the forest, she regained her courage. She realized that the old man was actually an illusion created by Moros to discourage her. Refusing to give in to fear, she spoke words of release she had learned from the forest spirits. With a cry of despair, the illusion shattered, revealing Moros retreating into the shadows, disappointed by his failure. Despite all the obstacles and trials, Rhea did not lose hope. Each step forward, each danger overcome, brought her closer to her final destination, finding the magical artifact that could save the forest. The trials were not only tests of her strength and courage, but also of her wisdom and compassion. Each encounter, whether with friends or foes, was a lesson, an essential part of her journey of self-discovery. Thus, Rhea continued to move forward, guided by the gentle light of Lycos and her own determination. With each challenge overcome, she felt herself growing stronger and more prepared for what lay ahead. Her trials were not just obstacles, but also opportunities to learn, to grow, and to become the true protector of the Silver Forest. Finally, after traversing numerous obstacles and trials, Rhea reached her destination, a grotto bathed in a silver light, so bright it seemed unreal. The grotto lay deep within the heart of the Silver Forest, a sacred and protected place, hidden from the eyes of the uninitiated. It was a natural sanctuary where the magic of the forest pulsed with the greatest intensity, and time seemed to stand still. Here, in this peaceful and sacred refuge, Rhea felt an ancient and wise presence that filled her with a sense of peace and reverence. In the middle of the grotto, on an ancient stone pedestal, rested the magical heart of the forest, an artifact of unparalleled beauty. It was a crystallized stone of exceptional clarity, emitting a silver light that seemed to dance on the walls of the grotto. Rhea approached with a mix of fear and awe, knowing that this was the object she had sought, the key to saving the forest and restoring natural balance. Before she could touch the artifact, an ethereal figure appeared before her, the spirit of the forest. The spirit, an ancient and wise entity, had an imposing yet gentle presence. With luminous eyes and a serene face, it spoke with a voice like a gentle breeze, asking Rhea about her motives. The spirit wanted to ensure that her desire to save the forest was pure, without personal ambition or a desire for power. It explained that Rhea must pass 3 trials to prove the purity of her heart and her true desire to protect the forest. The first trial was the trial of courage. The spirit created an illusion in which Rhea found herself on the edge of a deep chasm, with strong winds pushing her toward the edge. On the other side of the chasm, she saw a small, helpless child crying in fear. Rhea felt immense fear, but knew she had to save the child. Without hesitation, she used all her inner strength to cross the chasm, facing the winds and the fear of the unknown. When she reached the child, the illusion dissipated, and the spirit confirmed that she had successfully passed the first trial, demonstrating her courage. The second trial was the trial of wisdom. Rhea was placed in a magical landscape where all the plants and animals seemed to be in perfect harmony. There, the spirit showed her an old, sick tree on the verge of collapse, which supported the life of other plants and animals. Rhea had to find a solution to save the tree without disturbing the ecosystem around it. She recalled the knowledge passed down from her grandmother and the forest spirits, using it to prepare a healing potion from magical herbs. Carefully, she applied the potion to the tree's roots, which began to regain their vigor. The spirit smiled, recognizing Rhea's wisdom and knowledge in maintaining nature's balance. The final trial was the trial of the soul. The spirit of the forest presented Rhea with a vision in which a black dragon, a symbol of greed and destruction, devastated the last oases of greenery in a land depleted of magic. To prove the purity of her heart, Rhea had to find a way to stop the dragon without resorting to violence. Instead of attacking, Rhea approached the dragon with compassion, speaking to it about the power of transformation and offering it the chance to become a protector of the forest. She healed an old wound, demonstrating kindness and generosity. Moved by her gesture, the dragon chose to change its ways. This choice showed the spirit of the forest that Rhea understood the true power of compassion and empathy. With the trials completed, the spirit of the forest granted Rhea its blessing. Rhea reached out and touched the magical heart, feeling a powerful and warm energy envelop her entire body. The magical heart gave her an even deeper connection to the forest, a greater understanding of nature's delicate balance and her role as its protector. But before she could use this power to restore balance to the forest, Moros appeared, furious and full of hatred. The dark sorcerer was ready to destroy everything to achieve his malevolent goals. He tried to stop Rhea, casting dark spells and unleashing the forces of darkness. But Rhea was not alone. Lycos, the Silver Guardian, appeared by her side, ready to defend and fight for the forest. In an intense confrontation, full of magic and light, Rhea and Lycos combined their forces. With the help of the magical heart, they unleashed a burst of purifying light, an energy that pierced the darkness and enveloped the entire forest. This light not only drove away the forces of darkness, but also restored balance and harmony to the forest. Moros, unable to withstand this pure power, was imprisoned in a magical underground prison. A place hidden deep beneath the roots of the oldest trees in the forest, where he could no longer do harm. The world of the forest was thus freed from his malevolent influence, and the creatures and spirits of the forest could once again breathe in peace and safety. With the forest saved, Rhea felt a great peace in her soul. At that moment, she knew her mission was not just a simple duty, but a deeper calling to protect and respect nature. She became the new guardian of the forest, alongside Lycos, taking on the role of watching over this magical world and ensuring that harmony and balance would always be preserved. This story, though seemingly about a single girl and her guardian wolf, became a legend, reminding everyone of the importance of protecting nature and the responsibility we have to live in harmony with all beings. The magical world and the human world, though distinct, were more united than ever through the sacred bond Rhea represented. She learned and demonstrated that true power does not lie in strength or magic, but in courage, love, and respect for all living things. And so, dear listeners, we come to the end of our adventure in the magical world of the Silver Wolf. This story reminds us how important it is to love and protect nature, for within it lie our roots and the power to live in harmony. So, remember that in every dream lies a fascinating story, and in every corner of nature, a drop of magic awaits to be discovered. If this journey has brought you joy and warmed your heart, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you never miss a new magical story. What would you do if you could communicate with animals and forests, like Rhea? Would you use this power to protect nature's balance or explore the hidden secrets of the world? Share your thoughts and dreams in the comments. Until next time, I wish you sweet dreams and to live each day with open hearts to the wonders of nature.